Here we are. I think we are live. Perfect. So here we are. Thanks very much, David, for the opportunity. What we're going to do in this quick Facebook Live is we are going to talk about how to give a keynote presentation. Now, think about it. Wouldn't it be great to be able to create and design and deliver presentations that allow you to achieve your objective every single time? Wouldn't it be great to be able to create and deliver presentations that allow you to share your message, make an impact, and be memorable? That's what we're going to talk about in the next 20 to 30 minutes. Now, before we do this, just a very quick intro. My name is Andrea Pacini. I'm a public speaking and presentation coach. I'm the founder of Ideas on Stage here in the UK, but we are also in Paris, in Milan, and in Barcelona. In the last 10 years, we've been working with hundreds of clients from the small business owner and professional all the way up to clients like Microsoft, Lacoste, the World Bank. We've been coaching more than 300 TEDx speakers so far. So I'm very proud about our clients, as you can see. And we specialize in helping established business owners and professionals create and deliver powerful presentations. And my vision in the next 10 years is to help as many professionals as possible share their message, make an impact, and be memorable. Why? Because I don't know about your experience, but for me, everywhere I go, I see so many professionals who do have potentially a great message to share, but they struggle to present it in an effective way. And the problem with that is that today, having a good idea isn't good enough. I believe that great ideas need great presentations, which means that whenever a presenter takes time from an audience, they should give them something in return, which is at the very least worth their time, and why not, even stays in their memory. That's what I believe. Now, if you want to be able to present effectively, forget about PowerPoint and Keynote and all the different presentation tools, forget about technology. You see, most people focus on the wrong problem, and that is the problem. If you want to be able to present effectively, you need to have three skills. You need to have the ability to develop a compelling message. So the message, your story comes first. You also need to have the ability to amplify your message using effective visuals. You don't have to present using slides all the time, but when you do, you need to make sure that your visuals support your message. Because if they don't, they work against it. And that's why it's a problem. And then you also need to have the ability, the third ingredient, to deliver your talk in a way that's comfortable and convincing. So these are the three skills you need to have: your message, your visuals, and your delivery. And here's the thing. If one element is missing, you will find it hard to reach your objective. So it's like, think about it, it's like a stool with three legs. What happens to a stool with three legs if one leg is broken? It falls off, right? The same is true with presentations. If one element is missing, you will find it hard to reach your objective. So if you think that this is just about PowerPoint, because some people do, you've missed the point. If you're watching this, hoping to get some tips and tricks on how to use the presentation tool better, then you've missed the point. This is really about connecting. It's about a story, an idea, a message that gets communicated for you to be able to make an impact, for you to be able to be memorable. So you see, it's so much more than just a PowerPoint presentation. And what I want to do is I want to give you three key ideas, one idea per step. So we've talked about three key steps, three key ingredients you need in order to be able to deliver a great presentation: your message, your visuals, your delivery. And I want to share with you the three key mistakes that especially business professionals, most business professionals make for each of these three key ingredients, okay? And we'll start with the first one, the message. Now, the mistake I see is that what most business professionals do, the very first thing they do when they need to prepare a presentation is to either just open PowerPoint or any other presentation tool. It doesn't make any difference. So they either just open PowerPoint and put together some slides, or, which is a bit better, they start thinking about their key messages, what they want to communicate, which is definitely better than just opening PowerPoint, but it's not the very first thing you want to do. The very first thing you want to do is, if you think about it, if you want to come up with a compelling message for your audience, you need to start with the audience. When you give a presentation, it's their presentation, not yours. It's always the audience's presentation. Think of a presentation as a present. If I want to give you a present, it's your present, not mine. And so I need to make sure that I know you so that I can buy something that you like. A presentation is very similar. When you give people a presentation, it's their presentation, not yours. And so you need to make sure that you know your audience, definitely before you open PowerPoint, but also before you start thinking about your key messages. And how can you do that? Now, I'm going to share with you a very simple but very effective technique that we use when we work with our clients to help them prepare their presentations. We call it the ABC. Of course, we start with the ABC. That's the ABC of preparation. Audience, burning needs, context. ABC, audience, burning needs, context. So you need to ask yourselves some questions in these three key areas. Now, what kind of questions? For example, audience. Okay, who is your audience? Who are the key people in your audience? Which company do they work for? What are their job titles? If you don't know, can you ask around? Can you search on LinkedIn? Try to find out as much as possible about your audience. Otherwise, it's very hard to create something that works for them. It's their presentation. And then burning needs. Okay, what do they need? What do they expect from your presentation? What challenges do they have? How do those challenges relate to your activities? Do they have any concerns about your activities you may want to know? What do they expect to hear? What do they need to hear? And then context. At what time of day will you be presenting? In what kind of room? Is it a conference? Okay, will anybody be speaking before or after you? If that's the case, what will they be talking about? Maybe there are some connections, and again, you want to know. Do you want to show some visuals? Can you do that? Is there a screen or a projector? Will they give you a microphone? What kind of microphone? Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that you need to have an answer to all of these questions all the time, but would you agree? Think about it. Would you agree that you will be much better prepared than most people who, I can tell you, if we are lucky, the very first thing they do is to start thinking about what it is that they want to communicate. But you see, it's about them. It's never about the audience. And if we're not lucky, and 99% of the time we are not, they just open PowerPoint and put together some slides. Now, also, I'm not saying that you can't create a great presentation if you don't know your audience. You can, but the risk there is that perhaps you create a fantastic presentation for the wrong audience. For example, true story, some time ago, we were working with a client. Her name is Marine from Paris. Marine is an executive. She's an expert in leadership. And she was invited by an association in Finland to give a talk about leadership. It was one of her first international speaking opportunities, so she was super excited, and she prepared very well. She knew what she wanted to communicate. She also said that she had 50 beautifully designed visuals, and she also rehearsed properly, so she was ready to go. True story. She flew to Finland the day before the conference, and then arrived there on the day half an hour before the audience, because she wanted to make sure that she had time to set things up. And when she was about to connect her laptop to the screen, she realized that there was no screen. So a little bit of panic. She went on and asked the organizers, assuming that they would say, oh, sorry, now we are going to fix this for you. We are going to find a screen somewhere. But actually what they did was they started laughing. They started laughing. And so she said, why are you laughing? And they said, look, you've been invited to give a talk to the Association of Blind People in Finland, and you want to show 50 slides. Now, true story. I know extreme example, but it happened for real. Marine was very well prepared, apart from one thing. She didn't know her audience. She didn't even take the time to translate the name of the association from Finnish to French, and she would have realized that perhaps there was no need to have 50 beautiful slides. So that's the first mistake. Don't jump straight into the presentation tool. In order for you to come up with a compelling message for your audience, you need to start with the audience, okay? Now, let's move to the second key ingredient, the visuals. What's the mistake there? Now, in my experience, I often see audiences who, group of people who look bored and uninterested, resigned, maybe. And this is something that we see every day at schools, at conferences, business meetings. And one of the main reasons for that, it's not the only one, but one of the main reasons for them is, from a visual, from a design perspective, is the typical death by PowerPoint, right? This is where the speaker attacks the audience with bullet points and lots of text on the screen. But all that does is it kills your attention. It kills your audience's attention. Now, the problem with slides full of text is not that I don't like it. I don't like it, but that's not the problem. The problem is that people can't read and listen at the same time. If you look at how our brain works, the written text, if you show a slide full of text, the written text on your slide and the spoken text is processed in exactly the same parts of the brain. So if you are my audience, if I show you a slide full of text, you either read the text or listen to me. You can't do both activities at the same time, not even women. Sorry, not even women. So death by PowerPoint is a crime against your audience, and you don't want to do it. What's the alternative? The alternative is to create simple and visual slides that support, reinforce, and amplify your messages. You see, slides can be very powerful if that's what they do, if they amplify your messages, but they should never replicate what you say. Remember, when you present, when you speak in public, you are the presentation, not your slides. Think about this. Think about Piccadilly Circus. Let's go to Piccadilly Circus, and there you have the big billboards, okay? Now, if you think about it, why are those billboards, or maybe on the tube, they are often designed in a very visual way? They're big image, just a few words. Why is that? What do you think? Now, the reason for that is that because they have to capture our attention in just a few seconds. Isn't that true? They need to capture your attention in just a few seconds. Now, what if we apply the same principle to presentation design? Who says that the same principle shouldn't apply? Of course it should, also for business presentations. So consider these as a guideline for you if you want. When you show something on the screen for your audience to see, it has to be so simple that your audience should be able to understand the message behind it in no more than, say, 3 to 5 seconds. That's it. If that happens, then your slides are effective from a design perspective and therefore from a communication perspective as well. Things are connected. If that doesn't happen, then most likely you are also, and your slides are also, suffering from death by PowerPoint, and with you, your audience is suffering too. So the mistake here is that people confuse slides with documents. Slides and documents are not the same thing, and they should be separated. Documents, lots of text, that's fine. With slides, it should be different. Not so much text. Think about it. You wouldn't use your toothbrush to comb your hair just because it has bristles like your hairbrush. Now, I don't have the privilege of trying, but I would never try. A toothbrush and a hairbrush are two different things, and you use them for two different activities. Slides and documents are two different things, and you should use them for two different activities. So that's the second mistake you want to avoid, death by PowerPoint. And then finally, the third mistake around delivery, speaking in public, is that often when we speak in public, we build walls, barriers between us speaking and the audience. If you want to be able to present effectively, to deliver your talk effectively, you need to remove those barriers. I'm borrowing something here from a guy called Gar Reynolds. For those who don't know him, Gar is the father of effective presentations. And he wrote a book, a very famous book in this space called Presentation Zen, which I recommend. He also wrote another book focused on the delivery aspect of the presentation process, which is called The Naked Presenter. And he shares this idea that if you want to be able to present effectively, you need to be able to present naked. Naked. Now, when he says naked, I don't know what you're thinking about. I don't want to know. But presenting naked is about taking off your protection. It's about removing anything which is there just for your benefit as the presenter and not for the benefit of the audience. You want to make a connection with the audience, right? But if you think about it, it's hard to connect if you stay at a distance or behind barriers. For example, one of the mistakes I see all the time, we prepare our clients, speakers for conference talks, conference keynotes, presentations. And then we go there on the day, on these conferences, and not always, but often on stage, you see that there is a lectern. And if there is a lectern, isn't that true? We like it so much. And we start presenting from behind the lectern, or maybe in a business meeting behind a table. Why? Because it's our protection. A lectern is a protection between me and the audience. But what that does is it just accentuates the feeling of I'm up here, you are down there, teaching mode. Whereas what you really want to do is to be communicating with your audience, not just talking at them. There's a massive difference. So get close to your audience if you can, remove the barriers. And that's why, going back to what we were talking about before, another barrier you want to remove is the text on your slides. It's a barrier. It's a protection for you to remember what to say, but it doesn't benefit the audience. So of course, if you follow an approach, also from a design perspective, which is much more simple and visual, you need to know what you're talking about. You need to prepare properly. But just do it. I've got nothing to say here. Do it so that you never have to look at the wall behind you. You need to know your material so well that there is no need for you to turn your back and read from your slides. And that's another way you can establish that connection. Is this making sense? I hope so. So yeah, these were just some ideas on the three key ingredients you need in order to be able to prepare, design, and deliver an effective presentation. And you want to avoid those three key mistakes. Now, think about it. As a business owner or business professional or entrepreneur, as a coach, you are only as valuable as your ideas. If you can't persuade others to believe in your ideas, then they don't matter very much. And if you think about it, public speaking is the key to unlocking empathy and creating excitement and trust between you and the listener. It's the key to sharing knowledge and insights and painting a vision. And isn't that what you're trying to accomplish, perhaps as a small business owner pitching an idea to a new potential client, or as a professional presenting a new idea? Your goal is to create excitement and trust and empathy between you and the listener. Your goal is to share knowledge and insights and paint a vision. And effective public speaking is the one skill that can help you achieve all of these results. So if there is one skill, there's one skill that can help you boost your business or career, that skill is public speaking. Until you are a great presenter, especially for business people, until you are a great presenter, a great speaker, then your only job should be to become one. Think about it. Until you are a great presenter, your only job should be to become one. Now, and we are done. I hope it's been useful. Now, if there is just one thing I would really like you to remember and take away from this short Facebook Live, is that I believe that there's never been a better time to become a great presenter. Why? Because the nature of, especially for business people, especially for business professionals, because the nature of work is changing. If you look at what's happening with things like automation and artificial intelligence, today, having a good idea isn't good enough. If you think about it, if you want to sell products or land your dream job or lead teams or build brands or trigger movements, if you want to do any of these things, then you need to be able to persuade people. You need to be able to inspire them. And this is not something that a robot will be able to do, never. So that's why being able to present effectively is a skill that will become only more important, not less. So if you are watching this live, it's because maybe, maybe not, but maybe you are only at the beginning of your journey to becoming the best presenter you can be. And I can promise you, it's the smallest investment you can make in yourself in order to make the biggest difference to your business or career. So keep going, you won't regret it, and your audience will thank you. And I also want to thank you. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks, David, for the opportunity. I hope it's been useful. If you are interested in this topic, if you're interested in effective presentations, effective public speaking, feel free to send me a friend request. You'll find me here on Facebook. You'll find me on LinkedIn as well. And let's have a chat. I'd love to connect. I hope it's been useful. And thanks again. And I wish you a great week ahead. Cheers.